Hi everyone, I am Dr. Anisha and I welcome you to my channel. In the last video, we started a new topic of the oral pathology, that is epithelial tumors of the oral cavity. We had divided the lesions into three categories, benign tumors, then pre-malignant lesions, and finally malignant tumors of the oral cavity. In the last video, I started off with squamous papilloma, which falls under the category of benign tumors. And today also, I shall be moving on with one another benign tumor of the epithelial origin, that is your keratoacanthoma. So, before starting the discussion, I would like you to kindly subscribe my channel for further videos. So, let us start with the introduction of keratoacanthoma. The other terms which are used for keratoacanthoma are self-healing carcinoma, also known as molluscum pseudocarcinomatosum, also known as molluscum sebaceum, and finally verrucoma. So all these four terms are the synonyms for keratoacanthoma, and they are equally important for the viva point of view. Now, if I give you a brief introduction about keratoacanthoma, so the most important feature about keratoacanthoma is ये जो आपका keratoacanthoma है that is clinically and pathologically very much similar to your squamous cell carcinoma. Now there is a malignant lesion squamous cell carcinoma which you must be knowing it I suppose. So जो आपका squamous cell carcinoma है बिल्कुल उससे similar clinically like clinical appearance में and also pathologically it appears. All right. So, lesion is basically a common low-grade malignancy that originates in the pilosebaceous glands. So, all in all, your keratoacanthoma is very common low-grade malignancy, okay? And that is why it falls under the category of your benign tumors. And the most important thing which is associated with keratoacanthoma is the pilosebaceous gland. So, this was all about the brief introduction about keratoacanthoma. Now, let us move on to the causes or etiology of keratoacanthoma. Now, keratoacanthoma, as I already told you, is considered as an invasive squamous cell carcinoma or a variant of squamous cell carcinoma. Etiology usually remains very unclear, but then the reports have been suggested and few of the reasons have been, you know, noted due to which keratoacanthoma basically persists. So, agar main reasons ya etiology ki baat karu in, you know, occurrence of keratoacanthoma, to sabse pehle sunlight has been given as one of the etiology for keratoacanthoma. And जो दूसरी etiology या cause report की गई है वो है industrial workers में and due to that chemical carcinogens have also been reported as one of the etiology for your keratoacanthoma. Now few strains of human papilloma viruses have also been reported to be the reason for or the cause for keratoacanthoma and जो strains human papilloma virus के note हुए हैं they are 11, 13, 18, 16, okay, 25, 33, 37, 57 and these are the basically strains which are responsible for keratoacanthoma. Now apart from all these you know etiologies, genetic factor and immunocompromised state of the individual is also few reasons due to which keratoacanthoma can occur. And finally, trauma can also be one of the reason for keratoacanthoma. So, this was all about the etiology of the lesion. Let us move on to the clinical features of keratoacanthoma. And when I talk about age, so the age of occurrence is basically younger age and the incidence increases with increase in age. If I talk about gender predilection, so studies have shown that जो males होते हैं, they are, you know, two times more affected in comparison to females. Chances of keratoacanthoma जो है, वो males में females से twice probable होता है, okay? And when I talk about the type of skin in which keratoacanthoma is, seen very commonly. So the people who have darker skin and who have more melanin pigment in their skin are, less commonly affected by keratoacanthoma in comparison to those who have lighter skin tone. Okay. Now moving on to the location. तो अगर मैं location की बात करूं तो keratoacanthoma is more commonly seen on the face, neck and the dorsal surface of the upper extremities, and apart from these three areas they are more commonly seen in lip portion. Both the upper lip and the lower lip are commonly affected, and also the one of the most common area is the vermilion border. So these were the locations in which at which keratoacanthoma is more commonly seen in comparison to the other parts of the body. Now moving on to the clinical presentation of keratoacanthoma. जब आप keratoacanthoma के lesion को observe करेंगे तो firstly you will see a solitary benign lesion. Okay. Now the shape will vary from round to dome shaped. All right, and the color will be between skin color to reddish in color. If I talk about the consistency, it is going to be firm in consistency. Now, as I already told you, ये एक dome shape का ulceration होगा, wherein the ulceration will be present at the core in the central portion of the lesion. Now, this core or the central portion will be, filled by keratin plug. As far as size is concerned, तो ये जो lesion होते हैं, they are usually 1 to 1.5 centimeter in diameter. And as far as pain is concerned, yes, these lesions are painful along with regional lymphadenopathy. Now let us know something about the clinical course of the lesion. अगर आप keratoacanthoma lesion के clinical course को observe करेंगे, तो you will see that it is very unusual in nature. Firstly, the size of the lesion is very small when it starts growing, okay, and then it is firm in consistency, and over a period of 4 to 8 weeks it will grow to its full size. All right, so ek chhota sa keratoacanthoma ka lesion jo ki firm hoga consistency mein, wo 4 to 8 weeks mein apne full size tak pahunch jayega. Then if you observe again for 4 to 8 weeks, that full size keratoacanthoma lesion will be static in size. The size is gonna remain the same, and finally after 4 to 8 weeks it is gonna regress again. It will start regressing. There will be resorption of mass and also the expulsion of keratin plug from that keratoacanthoma, and again the size will decrease. So this is something which I have depicted with the help of a graph, how a keratoacanthoma, which is very small in size, firm in nature, it grows like it grows very consistently within the period of 4 to 8 weeks, and then it becomes very static at its full size and remains as it is within the period of 4 to 8 weeks, and then starts regressing with the help of expulsion of keratin plug and also resorption of mass. Now let us move on to the histological features of keratoacanthoma. Firstly, agar aap keratoacanthoma word ko split karenge, to you will get two terms. The first term says kerato, that means there will be something related to keratin. Also, acanthoma is the next word, and acanthoma histologically, is referred to squamous cells. All right, so there will be some problem in the squamous cells in this lesions, and so here I am connecting this term with the histological feature of the lesion. And histologically what happens is there is hyperplasia of the squamous cells, squamous epithelium, and the hyperplasia is so much so that it invades into the underlying connective tissue. So what happens is, जो आपका squamous cell होगा lesion का, जो भी epithelium है वहां पे site of lesion पे, वहां पे जो आपके squamous cells present होंगे epithelium के, that squamous cell will have hyperplasia. जो number of squamous cells होगा वो drastically बहुत ज्यादा हो जाएगा, and due to this increase drastic increase in number of squamous cells. The cells are going to invade into the underlying connective tissue. Now, the next point says, jo aapka surface hoga, again, I'll correlate the next point with that of the term, that is keratoacanthoma. So, jo aapka surface hoga, that is going to have orthokeratinized or parakeratinized surface, okay? And there also be central plugging made up of keratin is present. This is the most important point to be kept in mind. And keratoacanthoma shows dysplastic features at times. So this is the reason why it is known as the variant of squamous cell carcinoma, because keratoacanthoma occasionally shows dysplasia, जो आपके dysplastic features होते हैं, जो कि squamous cell carcinoma में present होते हैं, बिल्कुल उनके जैसा, बिल्कुल similar to that, some dysplastic features are also present in keratoacanthoma at times, occasionally, and so that is why I already told you in the beginning, ये जो आपका keratoacanthoma है, that is clinically and pathologically it resembles with the squamous cell carcinoma. Now, the next point says, at times, what happens is, your keratoacanthoma may invade the perineural spaces. All right. And finally, the thing to be kept in mind histologically is, the most characteristic feature of the lesion will be found at the margins of the lesion, where the adjacent normal epithelium is elevated towards the portion of the crater. Now, if you want to see the characteristic feature of the lesion, you will tend to get that at the border of the, you know, lesion, at the margin of the lesion, wherein the normal epithelium is elevated towards the crater or the ulceration found in the center of the lesion. So, this was all about the histological features of the keratoacanthoma. Now, let us talk about the treatment and prognosis of keratoacanthoma. Firstly, the most common line of treatment for keratoacanthoma is the surgical excision. And if the lesion is a recurrent one, or if there is recurrent keratoacanthoma, then the treatment of action is more aggressive. Now, as far as prognosis is concerned, definitely the prognosis of keratoacanthoma is excellent. And if spontaneous regression occurs, then definitely scar will be present in that area. There must be a follow-up. If at any point of time keratoacanthoma, you know, persists in the patient, because there are chances of new primary skin cancers, particularly squamous cell carcinoma. So this was all about the benign tumor of epithelial origin present in the oral cavity, that is your keratoacanthoma. If you liked the video, do like, share and subscribe. If you have any doubts, you can get back to me in the comment section. Now, from the next discussion, we are going to start with few pre-malignant lesions of the oral cavity. Thank you so much.